Lighthouse is flawed and you shouldn't trust it 100%. Hey guys, my name is Rahul Aire, and in this video we are going to see why am I saying that Lighthouse is flawed and what is my opinion on that. So think about for a moment, why do we use Lighthouse? So if you are a web developer, a digital marketer, or any other, you know, site performance tester, then you might be familiarized with what is Lighthouse and what it try to do. So basically Lighthouse gives us the analysis about and detailed report about how our site is performing, how our site is behaving, and if it goes above certain score, great, your site is performing good. If it goes bad, then your site needs to be calibrated so that it could be performed much more greater. Is it the case? You might say, yeah, that's what it is, and that is not the 100% accuracy. See, so let's try to imagine for a while that what might be the Lighthouse score for YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Quora, and bunch of other sites. Just think for a while. 80, 85, 90, 95, 100. 100 is just too much. So here are the results from Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Quora, and none of them even scored 90 in their Lighthouse test. So what is actually happening over here? See, the thing that Lighthouse really does is it tries to measure the speed test on the first visiting basis. So what do I mean by that? Let's say if you visit a new site which you haven't really visited in a while, naturally what it will do is it will take some time to fetch all the assets, do all the index.html, do css file, to load all the JavaScript and all the media access into our file, and that is what it kind of really tries to do, all of this analysis. And one thing that you should remember, that in 2021 at least, not all the sites are built the same. So major big pair sites, that what I've really said before, kind of really use some of the basic principles from the SPAs, or single page application, which are rented by JavaScript itself. So what is really happening right now is that Lighthouse will never give an accurate score based on the SPAs on all of that structure. So it is always really said that, you know, you should always use kind of really a server-side rendering like WordPress, Next.js, or any other framework to kind of really boost your SEO and to give a performance, which is kind of really true for a moment. So think for a while, if you are kind of really providing a SaaS service, if you're kind of really a social service provider, or sorry, social networking site like Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, or anything other than else, what will really happen is that your users will kind of really use your site for second, third, fourth, or fifth trial, or fourth consecutive uses. The way the Lighthouse really works is that it just works for, you know, first trial. It gives you about it. It just clears the cache and then it gives out the result for you. That means if you are really freshly visiting the site, then it gives you performance score about all of that. But the thing that you should remember is that, you know, when the users are going to visiting your site, they are going to use it for long-term basis. And you should really just take care in your mind that at least even if the site really loads slow for the first time, from the second and the third and the fourth consequent uses, it should load quickly. And that's what you can really see with the early, let's say, React site. So what really happens with the React is that it gives you the terrible score on the Lighthouse test, like what we have seen with the YouTube and all of that. But what really happens is that it caches everything on your browser, or it caches on your, let's say, a hard drive. And then what really happens is the next time that you really load it, it doesn't need to, you know, kind of really load the interface together. It just gets the API and displays you together. So that really makes the user experience much more better and enhanceful. So there are multiple strategies you can really avoid and use. Sorry, there are multiple strategies that you can use to, you know, amplify the experience and to really just kind of get some of that. See, we all agree on the one page that our site should have non-blocking asynchronous JavaScript code. Our media files should be optimized so that it can be served much more better. We always use, you know, the best compression format or algorithm. That is the best example is that I can see is WebP. You can use WebP in your browser and many other things. But there is a limit where you can optimize your site further and further. See, take for example this page, which I really mean by the dimension. It just tells you what your dimension is, and it gives me a perfect 100 score in this Lighthouse test. But what is the use of that? It doesn't have any content and still gives me 100 score. I would rather much more prefer to have a site which kind of takes a significant amount of time in its just first initial load, but it should give me much more decent experience, because the fact that we are going to use it for the next subsequent, let's say second or third trial, your site should have a better caching mechanism so that it could really store all of that website content, let's say pages. They can get the page view instantaneously. Contrary to having a 100 on 100 light score, you know, target itself, you should have a decent caching mechanism so that your site could get cached on the user's device itself, so that the next subsequent time it just gets load snappier. And if you're using the React, it just gets you done by out of the box. You don't have to do anything else. And the thing that really is, like, let's say if you take, for example, if you have a crazy animation, if you have really lots of, you know, effects and then trying to do a JavaScript effect, obviously it's going to take some time to really just kind of get you and loads up there. The fact that you really see the crazy, you know, the eye popping animations that we all love, what Apple is doing on their website, the video is fibbling with the scroll, the animation is kind of really just smooth when we scroll the web page. But you should really consider that it kind of takes a lot of scripting, it kind of takes a lot of CSS code, and it kind of takes a lot of rendering power to do all of that thing. And the fact that if you have really a lot of animation, if you have a lot of let's say style sheets, if you have JavaScript code, then you should remember that. And one thing that I just remember right now, that you should remember that, who are you serving? What is your target audience? So the fact that right now we are living in 2021, and the fact that we are talking about 5G itself, and especially in a country like India, where we have already it experiencing the geo revolution, everyone kind of has an alien high speed internet. So what it really means that you can really load the web pages fast enough in a really less amount of time. So what you can do is, right now, even if your site is having a really lot of size, you can optimize for experience, because the speed, consumer internet speed, has gone really up. And let's say if you're making a SaaS application for, you know, enterprise itself, there is a really high probability and chances that they are kind of having, you know, 100 megabit or gigabit internet at their premises, and which really means that they are not really consumed, they are not, you know, bound to about, you know, the speed performance, because obviously they are having that crazy fast internet which could really suck and pull the content from a server to their premises on their PC really instantaneously, fastly, which really means that you can really, you know, kind of really just neglect the speed concept, kind of really put it aside and just focus on the user experience. And now I do agree that, you know, the user experience kind of really labors on the speed. The better the speed, the better performance. But instead of trying to go and hop on the Lighthouse score, you should really see and try to just test on yourself that how is the feel and how is the look of that site. Is it really giving me better score? Is it giving me a better experience? Is it, you know, am I feeling really normal? Am I feeling really stressed, like less stressed or less worried? How is the experience for me? Like, let's just remove the Lighthouse score for a moment of the while. Am I really seeing it really fast? Great. Am I really seeing it, like, let's say all the content in a while, in a second or third row? Am I seeing it, you know, all of the content which I really need? Is everything there? If there is no error, then regardless of all of that thing which I have really said right now, you shouldn't really bother about Lighthouse score. Because as I really said, that not all sites are built the same. And you should always take Lighthouse score with a bit pinch of salt. That's not an entire thing. There are multiple things that you can do to optimize the site performance. Let's say content delivery network, let's say if you are using AWS S3 to host your website, you can use the CloudFront to really, you know, kind of really just distribute your website from edge location. And trust me, hosting your website on edge location does really helps a lot. So in my observation, that I was really just testing one API from US Virginia server from Amazon, and there I was getting a millisecond about, let's say response time about 200 milliseconds, 200, 250 milliseconds. and living in Mumbai itself. Let's say, when I chose the Mumbai server, I immediately got a response about 50 milliseconds. As I'm living in Pune, so the distance between Pune and Mumbai is just 200 kilometers. So as you can see, distance does affect the performance. So there are various methods you can improve the performance, and Lighthouse is not only one of them. And that's what I'm trying to say. By the way, if you are really interested up right now, you can check out my optimization video, which I have made a couple of months ago, up right here. And that's what I'm really trying to say. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think about it in the comments down below? And I'll be happy to get back to you. Till then, stay connected, stay subscribed, which is more important. I'll be back with next video.